Sup peeps, it's the dude from Beast Mode Gaming. Damn right. So we're basically gonna run Darkness War now. Me and some of my cabal peeps right there. I'll introduce you. There's Honey Beaver, that's my missus. And then we've got Jackie Chan, that's Paul. And then we've got Prodigal, that's Paul. Yeah, this one's Jeff. Yeah, right there. Yeah. That's Jeff. That's Paul.
Okay. Jeff is not noteworthy.
Yeah. And we're going to four-man it because our fifth left, and we don't actually have another fifth. So we're just going to four-man it, I guess. So the first place to start, obviously, is the build. So we'll get that same build that I've been using the whole time. As soon as I find it. There it is, tank rocket. Get that shit in there. You guys are all familiar with all these actives and passives and these augments over here. There's like no need to go into that detail. We've done that shit. If you don't know what I'm doing, go back to Polaris, go back to Hellraised, and you'll pick that shit up. Okay, sweet. Now that we've done that, let's begin the shit.
They came in terrible ships, riding creatures of nightmares, wielding powerful black magic.
HP, do you have dabs? Thanks.
So on the other two videos, the Polaris one and the Hellraised, I wasn't actually in TeamSpeak purely because those are the first two dungeons, and I think if you're just learning to tank, those are the ones you're going to do, and you're going to want to have full concentration for that shit. But by the time you got those two dungeons down, to be honest, I think you'll pretty much be okay with this one. This one's a piece of cake. That's why I'm in TeamSpeak now, because you don't need to concentrate that much in here. So the strategy on this fight is you don't lose your sprint. What you're going to do is, if you look where my mouse pointer is, you're going to run into there all the way in. Then you're going to turn around and run immediately to this bush. Then you're going to hit this ad a couple of times. And then you're going to run back there and hit the boss. And the reason why you're going to do that is because if you just attack over here, the boss takes about 6 seconds to spawn. By the time he's spawned and you start attacking him, this ad would have come and killed your healer. So you need to plan for that shit. Run there, don't lose your sprint. Run there, pick the ad up, hit the ad once. Run back over there, hit your agitation configuration, and kick the shit out of the boss. Also, while you're doing that, an ad is going to spawn over there, and you need to remember to pick this ad up as well. That's it, piece of cake. So let's put that shit into action. Paul, do you have short views?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. Since we're missing DPS, it's nice to have all the buffs. So let's do this. So watch this. I'm going to run in here, turn around, run to this bush. There's the ad. Hit him once. Get back here. Agitation. And now I'm going to pick this ad up that I was telling you about. Remember that ad? There's that ad. Now we're going to pick this dude up. We're going to whip his ass. Watch this. Piece of cake. Easiest boss kill in history. As long as you remember to get that ad from over there, you're all good. These two ads can hit really hard. What they actually do is they do an invisible cone attack, which I'm going to show you in a minute. So you're going to want to run behind them when they're doing the cone attack, and after they've done that, you can run back around again, like whoop their asses. Okay, let's do this. You're going to hit these dudes. So you see that? That's his cone attack. Move out of it. No worries. And then they die. Easy. I've seen those dudes one-shot a tank before. Because the tank thought he knew some shit, and then he didn't. Okay, so for this fight, what I like to do is I like to click on the boss, make sure the boss is selected at all times, because you're going to have to impair. So before I get into this, I'm just going to explain what we're going to do. Watch my mouse pointer. We're going to kill these two, then those two, then these three, then that bunch, in order. One, two, three, four, five. Just like that. Piece of cake. And sometimes you'll get some trigger-happy DPSs who will shoot these dudes and stuff. If you do, you got Art of War. You just run into the group, hit Art of War, and you'll pick them all up. Save the DPS's lives. It's all good. All in a day's work. That's how we roll. Okay, let's do this shit. We're gonna hit. One, two, and we'll just hang out over here a little bit. Watch my DPSs. It's going to be some trigger happy shit. My peeps are like Donald Trump on that shit. Watch this. I'm going to hit this dude over here. See? See? What did I tell you? Trigger happy deeps. These are Trump voters going on here. This is the shit I was talking about. Watch the shit. See, then they go and they kill the healer, kill the DPSs.
Sorry.
You see what I'm saying? I'm glad you guys got to see that. Now he's doing concuss. There we are. And I can get in there and whoop his ass. Now it's just a matter of kicking his ass. Whenever he does the giant AoE, the round circular thing, you can impair that. Otherwise, other than that, you don't really have to impair much. See, I can just run out of that. Why impair it? See, you can impair this. Nice low cost. It's all good. It's all good. We got this shit. See now you know what to expect. And my DPSs are good DPSs. You should see some of the DPSs. It's funny. They just kill everything.
The Norsemen came then upon our shores in longboats.
Okay, so for this fight, quite easy. What you do is you run up to this dude over here. Hit your agitation configuration. A lot of the times, I'm just going to explain a simple mechanic here. A lot of the times, the tanks can lose aggro on this fight, and purely it's because in the middle of the fight, the boss will do like a yellow AoE around his feet where the tank can't actually reach him. So you need to build up enough aggro before that point so you maintain aggro all throughout that cast. That's a long cast. The DPSs will never stop attacking the boss, however, you won't be attacking the boss. So they're generating aggro and you're not. So you need to make sure that you use your agitation early in the beginning of the fight. While the buffs are on, get your big molten steels out, build up a shit ton of aggro, and you can maintain that aggro throughout the cast of that AoE. If you can successfully do that, you're all good. And if you lose aggro, it's not your fault, it's not the DPS's fault, it's just purely because you cannot attack and they can. Okay, let's do this shit. My deeps are like right there. We're all here. So we're just gonna run. I like to step back a little bit. Now I can attack. Agitation. Buffs are on. Do your big molten steel hits, get some aggro generated in there, get all my builders. So now this is that AoE I was telling you about. Now I can't reach the boss, but they can. So all the aggro that I did just now, that's just maintaining. All my shit is like maintaining, if you catch my drift. There we are, piece of cake. That's how we kill shit. Power of all our rites and rituals, along with those of the Vikings. Who's my healer? Is it HP? Or Jeff? Woman standing tall with a weapon. How do I feel to heal, Jeff?
Feel fine.
Yep, you're not struggling?
No.
There we are. You heard that from the healer's mouth. So as long as you do this shit exactly the way I'm showing you, with all the shit exactly the same as I've shown you before, it's all good. So this part of the fight, you need to make sure all your DPSs are already through this wall. If one is behind this wall and you start pulling these mobs, you're going to get extra mobs that come out of freaking nowhere. You need to make sure everybody's through here before you begin. So what I'm going to do is watch this. Watch this. No one's going to attack anything. I'm going to run up to here and Ed is going to spawn here in a second. One hit. Dodge roll. One hit. One hit, one hit. So you just do a single hit on all those dudes, and there they die. You see this rock over here? I'll show you where I am. This, if you stand with the boss over here, he can't hit you with his giant column attack. That's awesome. Watch this. I'll show you. Hit agitation. Here's my good rock. I like to start with audible purely because it's nice damage mitigation. There we are. Sorry, we couldn't hear you, Jeff.
So, sorry, Sherlock. I had somebody else targeted by mistake. That's why you weren't getting healed.
I was watching my health, but because I started with Art of War, I thought that was the case. So, the technique that we're going to use here is called the burn technique. Because there's only four of us, it probably won't work. But I'll explain the theory of this. What we're going to do is we are literally going to overwhelm the shit out of this boss. He's going to shit himself. Watch this. So we're going to wait for the buffs to come off cooldown and the stems and all that other shit. Once that's done, only the tank and the healer is going to attack. Nobody else is going to attack. Then there's going to be like a weird orb type thing that comes out of this dude's head. That is going to be like the direction he's going to teleport. So he could teleport to here. Or he could teleport to here. Or he could teleport all, if you look where my mouse pointer is, all the way at the back over there. So most of the time he goes to the back over there. If he does that, we're all just going to rocket launch there. We're going to hit the buffs and we're literally going to kick his ass right there where he stands. And that's it. End of the fight. Otherwise, what he's going to do is he's going to go up there to the top. This entire floor is going to be AoE covered. We're going to get ads coming from all over the place. We don't do any of that mechanical bullshit. We just burn the shit. Everybody good? Yep, everybody got the stems and shit off cooldown? Yep.
Yep.
Paul, you good? Yep. Jeff, HP?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, sweet. See, they're being nice and well behaved and quiet and shit, so we can do this demonstrational shit. Normally they don't keep quiet.
Jeff paid me a lot of money.
Yeah.
To be quiet, and so yeah.
And it's worth it.
You stuck the money all around his butt over here, like all in there, like in the jeans. Okay, let's do this shit. So just myself and the healer gonna attack. Nobody else is gonna attack. Don't stand in that red AoE. Make sure you tell your DPSs because you can only impair that once. And the boss becomes immune too. See, okay, so you can see the direction he's going. This way. There we are. So we're gonna kick his ass. And he's dead. So we don't do any of that mechanical bullshit. See. That's what happens. Why don't you try and teleport now, bitch? Watch this, I'm gonna teabag him. Okay, he's gone. He got scared.
I think it was your lack of taste that frightened him.
He got scared. He saw my teabag coming down.
You do realize you're on a gold character, right?
Oh yeah.
One sec, guys, I just gotta equip something.
Yep, no worries. So while all this shit's going on, I'm gonna explain the tactics on this fight. So it's a good thing you guys can see my screen nice and big. So if you look where my mouse pointer is right here, there's like a half moon sun type deal going on down there. So basically that's where we're gonna kill these bastards. We're gonna jump down, right? Oh shit, I nearly jumped down. It's a bad thing. I'm going to jump down there, and these bastards are going to come and we're going to kill them around here. Then what's going to happen is, you see where that sun is over there? The boss is going to land over there once all these dudes are dead. I'm going to start the fight by standing just on the edge of the cliff. He's going to do a cone attack. You're just going to walk casually out of the cone attack, closer this way, stand about there, and then attack the boss. Make sure to use your agitation configuration, especially since in the second phase there's a major damage boost and the DPS can very, very easily pull aggro. So There's nothing to impair on this fight. If you look around here, these big chief looking bastards, that dude over there, that dude over there, that dude over there, that dude over there, they cast this weird AoE shit on the floor. You don't actually have to impair it. All that makes is these dudes over here, it just makes them attack a little bit harder, run a little bit faster, but it's not such a big deal if you miss one of those, and it won't damage you at all. It's purely a damage boost for them. It doesn't damage you in any way. So you don't have to dodge out of it or run or freaking die or anything. You literally just stand there and take it. Yeah, pretty much it. Okay, everybody good? Paul, you good? Yeah. NHB and Jeff, yeah. Okay, sweet. Both do the shit. Another thing I like to do is I like to tell my DPSs to make sure they're behind me, because you'll see there'll be DPSs running around over here, and there'll be DPSs over there, and the ads will just run to them first. And that's no good, because then they'll die. They have to run to the tank. See, that's that shit I was telling you about. Just let it go off. Who gives a shit? I got sidetracked there, but anyway, as I was saying, yeah, I don't remember what I was saying. It's all good. It'll come back to me. Oh yeah, yeah, I remember now. You need to make sure that the DPSs are behind you, because if they're not, the ads will run to them first. They'll get killed, and then they'll go, oh, still aggro, still aggro, like you know, like our DPSs get. Meanwhile, it was their own stupidity. So you remember, I'm on the edge of the cliff. This is where my fight starts. Shit, don't stand in that. There we are. I was pressing the wrong button there. My bad. Yeah, sometimes this filth can be invisible, and that is never a good sign. Reanimation. When he does the reanimation cast, you want to come back here and you want to pick these dudes up. I just use like one blade consumer. Pull the asses. It's all good. It's all good. Now we wait. It's like watching paint dry. Art of War, get the MP on that one. Luckily they've nerfed the cooldowns on this Art of War, these elite abilities over here, so it's only 35 seconds instead of 45. Now I feel like I can actually use that ability in a fight. Incoming damage boost. Honey Beaver was just reminding me about the times when DPS was so scarce that we had to use the buffs on the ads to make sure that they didn't kill all the freaking the healer. Those were the days. Now our DPSs are like beasts. They literally just kill this shit. And now it's a rinse and repeat of what we did just now, except with a major damage boost. Same thing, exactly the same. If you get into the habit of doing it a certain way, oh shit, I'm screwed. You see there what happened there? One of the ads blew up and killed me. But it's all good. If you get in the habit of doing it the same way every time, it'll just become so easy.
What happened there, Sean?
One of the ads was buffed. And he ran. He didn't casually walk nice and slow. He just sprinted straight towards me and exploded on me and knocked me off. Yeah.
Running bomb. Okay.
Yeah.
That's another good reason why we kept the dead ads as far away from the boss as we can.
That means when they come back to life, it takes them longer to reach us, which means we have more time to kill the boss, which is awesome. And that's the end of DW. I can't think of anything else from a tank's point of view or perspective. I think as long as you just do all the shit that you just saw and just repeat that shit, you'll be fine. It's all good. That's it. Any messages, you know, just drop them down below. If you have any gear questions, glyphs, signets, augments, whatever the heck it is, you just pop it down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it. If you don't like it, leave a thumbs up anyway. It's all good. Okay, see you later.